वेलकम एवरीबॉडी। सो वी हैव स्पोकन अबाउट दिस थीम मेनी टाइम्स बिफोर, बट इट इज ऑलवेज वेरी प्लीजिंग टू हियर अबाउट आंडा एंड एवरीवन लाइक्स टू हियर इट, सो इट्स ऑलवेज अ प्लेजर टू रिपीट। Bhumi Devi had learned from Varahadev that there are two things that give immense pleasure to Lord Varahadev or to Lord Krishna. What are those two things? One is when devotees come together and glorify him by chanting his holy name. And another way is when devotees offer him a flower garland or worship him with flowers. So these two things give him immense pleasure. When Anda heard about this, she was so happy that such simple things give so much pleasure to the Lord. So she thought that she should appear in this world and demonstrate how to perform devotional service in this way. So she appeared as the daughter of Keri Alvar, and from the very childhood, she was brought up in Krishna consciousness. And in this way, she exhibited great love for Lord Krishna because she grew up listening to the stories of Lord Krishna. She only ate prasadam. She assisted her father in all kinds of services because they lived in a small village called Srivilliputtur, which is in Madurai. Even now it is there. And in this village, it is one of the 108 Divya Desams. And the presiding deity over there is Lord Vattapatra Shahi. And Periyarvar used to worship this Lord in the temple in Srivilliputtur. And his entire family, and especially Anda, used to assist her father in worshiping this Lord. And her main service was, just like her father, flower service. Her father would grow flowers in his own garden. With his own hands, he would grow flowers. He never bought flowers from outside. It seems flowers that we grow ourselves in our own garden, they are the best quality flowers to offer to the Lord. They are always preferred. And only if we cannot grow our own flowers, the last option is to buy flowers from the market. But in any case, we should never pluck flowers from others' garden and offer it to the Lord. Or even from public places, we should not pluck flowers. Or if we go to temple, we shouldn't bring extra flowers from there and offer to the Lord. So it is said that the best possible way is to grow our own flowers and offer them with love. So those kind of flowers are very dear to the Lord. So Anda used to assist her father in doing this service. And from her very childhood, she had developed this desire to marry Krishna. She wanted Lord Krishna as her husband. And she would always keep insisting to her father that, when can I marry Lord Krishna? So her father was initially telling her that he will find a nice devotee for you in this world who performs devotional service nicely and everything, and you can be happy with him by performing devotional service. But Anda was never satisfied with that. She wanted to marry Lord Krishna only directly. So since she was insisting this for a very long time, Periyarvar, he said one day that, okay, since you are desiring very strongly, if you are very sincere, the Lord will come and marry you. You keep performing your devotional service. So Anda had great faith in her father. He was not just her father, he was also her spiritual master. So since her father and spiritual master had now told her that, yes, if you are sincere, Krishna will come and marry you, she developed a lot of faith that, yes, this will happen. And she knew that someday it will happen. So till then, what to do? She decided, let me glorify him by chanting his holy name and continue to do all other services that way. So she decided that she will follow a particular vrata called Pavai Nombu. Just like the gopis perform this vrata in Vrindavan, the Katyayani vrata, so Andal decided following in their footsteps, she will perform this vrata. It seems this performing of this vrata in this period, in this month of Margal, is very special. Because as we know, this month itself is very special. Krishna says, Margana Margashirshoham. I am the month of Margashirsh. Margashirsh means what? Margashirsha. It shows direction. It shows direction to all the living entities. It is the greatest among all the paths. And it is among the months, Lord Krishna says, I am Margashirsh. And another beauty about this month is the Brahma Murta of the demigods. So whatever is done during this month, devotional activities, it increases our faith and the results are manifold. So Andal decided to do this vrata. And also in Skanda Puran it is said, the Lord himself says that whoever performs this Margashish vrata, in exchange to that vrata, I give him myself. So this also Andal had heard. So she decided to perform this kind of a vrata. It's a month-long vrata. And surprisingly, I heard that it is not that only in South India this vrata is observed. Even in North India, this Margashish vrata is observed. There are many people even now in North India, who are in Uttar Pradesh and Rajasthan, many places like that, who perform this vrata. And how to perform this vrata, it seems every day, this is also mentioned in the Skanda Puran, that one performs this vrata by eating moong dal khichdi, rice moong dal with some basic spices, and ginger is also mentioned. So this kind of a khichdi is eaten in this month, and then one absorbs in chanting the holy names and performing various kinds of devotional services. And another thing is that one is supposed to get up very early during Brahma Murta, during this vrata in this month. So Andal decides that, okay, as long as I'm in this world and till the time Krishna comes and I get married to him, let me perform this vrata so that Krishna comes fast and I can get married to him. So she decides that she will perform this vrata, and she has also heard about the greatness of this vrata, that gopis performed it and Skanda Puran also mentions it. So she decides that she will also perform this Pavai Nombu. Pavai in Tamil means a deity. Nombu means vrata. So worshipping a deity, an archa vigraha, during this month is called Pavai Nombu. So she decides to do this. Now the beauty is, she wants to do this vrata, but she is not going to do it alone. She wants to do it along with all her friends. So she gathers all her friends and she tells them about this vrata, how to perform it, what all they should do. Now, in her internal mood, Andal, it is called as Bhavana Prakash. So in her internal mood, Andal is already transformed to Vrindavan. She is not present now anymore in Sri Villiputtur. She has already got transformed to Vrindavan internally. That is called as Bhavana Prakash, where a devotee is present in some place, but through his internal mood, he has reached to some other place and taking part in some pastime of the Lord. So we hear this in the life of many pure devotees, and who would transform themselves internally to some other part of the Lord's Leela. So this is what happened to Andal. She completely transformed herself in the mood of a gopi. Why? Because she understood, she had heard from her father that the mood of a gopi is most suitable to attract Krishna's devotional service and his love. And gopis had perfected that. So gopi bhava that we have heard, what even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu taught us, that gopi bhava is the most ideal and most suited for to attract Krishna's love. So she transformed herself into a gopi and into gopi bhava. And not only herself, she started seeing her entire village as Vrindavan. She saw all her friends like gopis. She saw the temple of Batapatra Shahi as Nanda Bhavan. And the deity itself, she saw as Lord Krishna, present in Nanda Bhavan. So in this way, she completely transformed herself to a time when Krishna is still present, performing leelas as Krishna in this world and in Vrindavan. Because Krishna was performing all these wonderful pastimes in Vrindavan, and he manifested all his divine qualities in Vrindavan. So she wanted to be there. Now, let's see what is happening in Vrindavan. In her Bhavana Prakash, it's a beautiful scene. It's a moonlit night. It is a beautiful sand of the Yamuna River. And in Vrindavan, there is a big, there's a kind of tension going on. What is the tension? What is the worry? All the elderly people in Vrindavan are discussing that they are going to experience a very severe drought in Vrindavan. And this drought is going to cause a lot of problem, because there will be no rain. If there is no rain, they cannot grow any crops. There will not be enough fodder for the cows. And in Vrindavan, they are all covered community. They have cows. They depend on cows, milk and crops. So this kind of a drought can cause a lot of problem for their occupation. So all the elderly people, the older people, senior citizens were discussing about this. And how did they come to know? Because there was a future teller, an astrologer. This astrologer told them that this kind of a drought is coming up very soon in Vrindavan. Now, all this was also Krishna's arrangement. Why did Krishna arrange this? Because it seems Krishna and the young gopis in Vrindavan would often meet. And the gopis would, they loved to meet Krishna, and this was now becoming very noticeable by the elders over there. So when these older people saw that the girls are often meeting Krishna and they are laughing and kind of having good time together, they did not like it. They thought that this is not good for their character, especially their daughters, small girls. Who will marry them if they keep giggling with Krishna like this? They did not like this. So they wanted to stop all this. So collectively, all of them had stopped all their daughters and granddaughters from meeting Krishna. They had blocked them. They said, nobody should go out of this house, all the girls. Just stay at home and take care of the household. Whatever you need, we will bring it from outside for you, and you will not go out anywhere. So the girls were very unhappy. What is this? We cannot meet Krishna. So many days had passed like this, and these girls couldn't meet. Even if some girl would try to escape and somehow meet Krishna, it seems that their elders would be sitting right at the door, blocking the way. Or if they were married girls, then the mother-in-law, father-in-law would keep telling them some work. Okay, you want to go out? Go after this work. Go after doing that work. So in this way, for many days, they were not able to meet Krishna. So Krishna himself had arranged that this astrologer will tell them there will be a great drought, and all the people in Vrindavan are going to face this drought. So these people were very worried what to do, how to overcome the situation. So this astrologer said, yes, there is a nivaran for everything. There is a solution. So the solution is that the young girls should perform a vrata. And if they perform this vrata, Katyayani vrata, then this drought can be overcome. They should be small girls. And how the astrologer told them that this vrata is performed in this particular fashion. They have to get up very early in the morning at 4 o'clock, take bath, go to the river Yamuna, and how they should worship the deity, and they should eat this particular prasadam. So when all the elderly people heard this, they were thinking that, oh, this is very difficult. Who is going to take all these young girls to the bank of Yamuna that too early in the morning in the Brahma Murta? Very difficult. So one old man said, no, I already have knee pain. Someone said, I have joint pain. I have shoulder pain. I can't get up so early in the morning. And nobody was willing to accompany the girls so early in the morning. So one of the leaders said, okay, let's do one thing. We have this young fellow, Krishna. Let us give him this service. Let him take all the girls every day. So he is the thief whom we are trying to avoid their meeting. But let's engage the thief himself. Then the problem will be solved. So everybody agreed. So no problem. Let us engage Krishna himself as a caretaker of all the girls. And he can take all the girls every day and bring them back safely. So they all approached Krishna that, okay, see, we are giving you this task and you should be the caretaker and take all these girls every day because you're the young boy and you have to bring them back safely. Initially, Krishna said, no, I am not going to do all this. I have no time and I'm not even interested. So they started saying, no, see, you're the young boy in our village. We are our old people and we can't do this so early in the morning. And this is also your problem because this drought is going to come in Vrindavan. So you're also part of Vrindavan. You have to help us. Krishna said, no, I'm not interested. They said, why are you not interested? Krishna said, no, if I go with them, you'll again start pointing at my character, saying that, hey, you spoke with this girl, you danced with that girl, you sang with this girl. So I don't want to go with them. So initially, Krishna was kind of, trying to push it aside. And like we say in Hindi, na bhav khano. So he was doing that. So then he said, okay, since you all are insisting so much, I will do it. Then it was decided, okay, Krishna will be their main leader. He will be taking them and bringing them back, all the young girls. And among the girls, they needed a local leader. So who will be this local leader? They appointed one of the gopis who will be the local leader of all the gopis, who will collect all the gopis together and pass on local information, like a local WhatsApp group. So Andal was that local leader among all the girls. Because now remember, Andal is in Vrindavan, inner Bhavana Prakash. So Andal is that local leader among all the gopis. So now Andal calls all the girls, young girls, for a meeting. That is one day prior to the beginning of their vrata. So Andal calls all the girls with a beautiful scene, moonlit night on the bank of the Yamuna, beautiful soft sand. All the girls come together over there and it's night time. Though it's night time, they are allowed to go out of the house. Why? Because they are going to meet for a very important purpose. So Andal tells them that how we are, Andal directly tells them about the purpose of the meeting. She tells them that we are performing this Margali Vrata. And after that, she immediately tells them the Phala Shruti. She tells them that we are going to get, we will get pure devotional service for the Lord. And after saying all this, she addresses the girls that you are all very fortunate young girls and you all are very fortunate that you are going to perform this vrata. So since that subject matter was so important, Andal tells the subject matter of the vrata, of the meeting first, and later she addresses all the girls. Now, very interestingly, Andal in every song of hers, she has filled her songs or her verses with very, very auspicious words. She calls these girls as very auspicious ones. Why they are auspicious? She says that they are all very beautifully decorated with ornaments, and they are having a very beautiful natural smile. So what are this, what is, so she also explains why they have this beautiful smile on their face. First of all, our shastras say that it is very auspicious to see a girl or a woman who is decorated with ornaments. Ornaments, like auspicious ornaments, like bangles, necklace, like especially like we say na, suhag ke chinna. So when a lady is, when we see a woman who is dressed with ornaments beautifully, it's a very auspicious sight. We can be assured that yes, this will, our day will be very good, because we have seen a woman with who has dressed up with very auspicious signs. Now we have to understand what is auspicious, not in a very flamboyant way, the way people may be dressing up nowadays, but in a traditional way which does not invoke another person's lust, which will only invoke feelings of goodness. So this kind of auspicious way of dressing. So this is how all the girls were dressed, and Andal says that this is very auspicious. And why? Because this creates auspiciousness to even those people who look at such girls. And then she says that they were having very nice smile on their face. So Andal says only people who have very good Atma Gunas, who are having very good qualities in their mind, qualities, devotional qualities, and were practicing them very nicely, only such people can have a natural smile on their face. Not a plastic smile, but a natural smile. And then she tells them the Phala Shruti even before they begin this Vrata. The Phala Shruti is that when we perform this Vrata, we are all going to get pure love for Krishna. That is the Phala Shruti. So in this way, she calls all the girls and starts performing. And then there are some question answers that go on. All the girls, they tell her that, okay, very nice, we are going to do this Vrata for Lord Krishna. First, she tells them that we are going to perform this for Lord Narayan. And then the girls say, who is this Narayan? We don't know Narayan. He says, Are, don't worry. Narayan means our Nanda Gopa's son, our Yashoda's darling. He is only Narayan. He is Narayan for the rest of the world. But for us, he is Krishna. For his intimate devotees, he is Krishna. But his formal name is Narayan for all the other people. So she says that we are about to perform this Vrata for him, for this Krishna. Now, the girls are also not ordinary. They are also very great devotees of the Lord. And we already saw how they all had this very good Atma Guna. That means good qualities, devotional qualities they were filled with. So one of the girls asked that, if Krishna is going to already give us this kind of a Phala Shruti, what is the need for us to do anything anymore? So Andal says, no. Even if Krishna is going to give us everything, as his devotees, we should perform. We should also endeavor to perform devotional service. And we should do whatever we can, whatever is possible for us to do. Yatha kinchit. Whatever little we can offer to him, we must do that. So she tells them that we must offer our devotional service to him. So then she says that how during this Vrata we are going to do, there are some do's and don'ts. So she tells them how we will not waste time in decorating ourselves, in eating very luxurious food stuff. We will not criticize anybody. We will also not take part in Bhagavat Ninda. That means criticizing others and many such things. And what we are going to do, we will get up very early in the morning, take bath, and we will chant the holy names of the Lord. At the same time, we will give a lot of charity to people. And we will meditate on the path of devotional service. And we will do it very happily. We will perform this vrata very happily. We will never think that, oh, I have to do this vrata. Not in that mood. We will do it very happily. Now, one of the friends, one of the gopis, asks a very interesting question. She says that, you know, Andal, we are going to perform this vrata. Now, the external reason why we are performing this vrata is because these people in Vrindavan, they are making us do it because they want rain. They want to overcome this drought and they want rain. That is what the astrologer has told them. That is the reason why they are letting us and they are allowing us to go out and perform this vrata. But all of us, our internal mood, our internal desire to do this vrata is because we all want Krishna. So there is a contradiction. So how, which Phalashruti is going, are we going to get? Will our village people get rain? Not only their village, will the people around us get the rain, or are we going to get Krishna? So which of the Phalashruti is going to will be true? So Anda, she very nicely tells them that if we perform devotional service and if we chant the holy names of Krishna, then all this rain and everything is just a byproduct. Everything will happen. We don't have to separately endeavor for the rain and all those things. She goes ahead to tell in great detail how the crops will grow very nicely. The crops will grow not only horizontally, they will also grow vertically. And the cows will be very healthy. They will give a lot of milk. So she speaks about green revolution, white revolution. She speaks about all the living entities around. The bees will have a lot of honey from the flowers. That means there will be a lot of flowers also that will grow in the farm. And the fishes will be very stout and healthy. They will get enough place to swim. That means there will be so much water in the ponds and lakes. So she speaks about the entire social diversity, how by performing this vrata, the main thing that we are going to do is we are going to chant the holy names together, chant the name of the holy of the Lord together. And by doing that, we don't have to separately endeavor for anything else. Other things are going to happen as a matter of fact, as a byproduct. Incidentally, everything will happen. So she speaks about this. And then another girl asks that, oh, but how is it possible? You're saying that it is going to be possible. But what if Krishna, he is, Krishna may give this, but what about the demigods? They have to agree to do these things because sometimes they may pose some obstacles. So she says that, okay, I will demonstrate what I just told you. And just while they were speaking about all this, Andal shows them that the Parjanya Devata comes right over there. So Andal calls him and she gives him a set of instructions how he should send rain. So that's a very elaborate set of instructions. How she tells them, she tells this Parjanya Devata how he should rain, how every activity that he does should remind them of Krishna, how the black rain clouds, the lightning in the sky should remind of Krishna's Sudarshan Chakra, the thundering should remind them of Krishna's Panchajanya conch, and everything. And at the same time, the rain should not be destructive rain. It should give protection to everybody. So she demonstrates how this rain is going to take place. And when this Parjanya Devata asks that, okay, should I rain now? Should I start raining? So Andal tells him, no, not now. Wait. If you rain now, then these people will stop our vrata. So you should rain only after we complete our vrata. We are yet to go to Krishna's house. We are yet to meet him. And we are yet to perform the vrata. So let all those things happen. Let us meet Krishna. and at the end of the month, then you pour rain. So then all the village people will also understand that yes, yes, because of our vrata, they got rain. If you already rain now, they will say, it has already started raining. So come back home. No need of all this vrata and all that. So she tells them very nicely that you should rain. Your rain should be as a result of our vrata. So she sends them back. So the girls understand, oh, that was a very beautiful live demo, how all this is going to happen. Now, there's another girl. She has a very brilliant doubt. She says that, see, this Krishna, he's a Mayavi. He can do any kind of Maya. So we cannot believe him so much that everything the way you said will happen. She quotes a story of Uttama Maharshi. So this Uttama Maharshi was there during the time of Mahabharata, and he was very sad that why Krishna allowed all this. Sorry, not Uttama, Uttanga Maharshi. So he is very sad why Krishna allowed this Mahabharata war. He could have stopped it. He thought that whenever Krishna comes to my ashram, I will definitely ask him. I'll in fact fight with him. Why did you not stop this Mahabharata war? So after the war was over, Krishna is going back to Dwaraka. On his way back, he comes to the ashram of this Uttanga Maharshi. So Uttanga Maharshi says that, oh Krishna, you should have stopped this war. Why didn't you stop the war? For you, anything is possible. So Krishna tells him, no, no, Uttanga Maharshi, everything happens by people's karma. Nothing is in my hands. I tried to tell them, you see, I went as Shanti Dut. I tried to convince Duryodhan, but he did not listen. Ultimately, karma is very strong. I cannot do anything. So Uttanga Rishi was not very convinced. He said, no, no, Krishna, you could have done it. Krishna says, okay, forget it. It's all over. I have come here now. If you have any desire, you tell me, I can fulfill that for you. So Uttanga Rishi said, okay, I am staying here in this desert area of Gujarat, Rajasthan, and there is no rain over here. When I perform my tapasya, I am good. But when I come out of my tapasya, that time I feel very thirsty. So can you arrange for amrut? When I come out of my tapasya, you arrange in such a way that I get amrut to drink. Nectar. So Krishna says, done. You will get it. You just think about me, think about our talk now, and you will get it. So Krishna says, okay, and he leaves his ashram. So then later, Uttanga Rishi goes into his tapasya. He does his tapasya, and when he comes out of his tapasya, he's very thirsty. So he thinks about Krishna. Yes, that day he had told me like that. Now I want amrut. Please arrange for it. And at a distance, he sees a person. Somebody is bringing something in a bag. So he goes near him. And he was a very ugly looking man, not very sophisticated. But he said, no problem, but he had something in his hand. So he said, this man said, I have brought amrut for you. Krishna has sent me. He says, Uttanga Rishi says, he has brought amrut. He's saying, but the bag that he has brought in, that is not an ordinary bag. It's a bag made from dog skin. So Uttanga Rishi says, hey, what is this? Amrut in dog skin? I cannot take such kind of things. This is very contaminated. So then this man says that, see, I don't know all that. Krishna told me, go and give this Rishi Amrut. I have brought it. I got this bag. If you want, you take it. So Uttanga Rishi says, no, 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 I cannot take. And also, he has brought it in a dog skin. And on top of that, this man also doesn't look very clean. He himself looks very unclean and shabby. I cannot take from such people. So Uttanga Rishi says, no, no, I don't want. So then this man says, okay, if you don't want, I'll go. He goes, immediately disappears from there. And when he disappears, Uttanga Rishi hears a big laughter sound. He turns around. That's our Krishna. Uttanga Rishi says, why are you laughing, Krishna? And how did you come here again? So Krishna says, I told you, Uttanga Rishi, karma is very strong. See, I arranged for you amrut, but you did not drink. He says, what is this? You arranged amrut for me, but you send it in a dog's skin. How can I drink that? So Krishna said, see, I sent you amrut. You should have had complete faith that Krishna is doing it for me. And you should have drank it. But you did not have faith in me. You you just kind of judge that this man does not look good. Do you know who it was? He was actually Lord Indra. He himself came to bring Amrit for you. And you yourself judged that this is dog skin. Who told you? You yourself made such judgments externally and you rejected that. You did not have complete faith. And this Indra, I had only sent him. This Indra told me that this man does not have faith in you. You don't send Amrit for him. But I had told him, go and give him. Now Indra himself is not very interested in sharing his Amrit with anybody. So he did all these kind of things. But you should have drank it. That's what I told you. That see, one's karma is very strong. It was not there in your karma. So you rejected it. Though I arranged it. Similarly, I tried to stop the Mahabharata war, but karma was very strong, so they did not stop it. So in this way, Krishna convinced him, and he went away. So Uttanga Rishi was also confused. So this girl, she quotes this story, one of the friends of Andar, and she tells Andar that Krishna can do this kind of maya. He has now shown us that now there will be good rain. This demigod will come and he'll pour rain and everything. And at the end of Vrata, there'll be nothing. Then what are we going to do? He will say that, you people had a lot of you people had some sinful reactions. Your past reactions only came as obstacle. So you will not get your Phalashruti. You'll neither get devotional service, love for Krishna, nor will you get any rain. Because your own sins or past sinful actions, reactions, they themselves are the cause of your not getting your phala. So Krishna can do that. Then what are we going to do? So then Andar tells these girls that yes, you're talking about our own past sins, but the Lord holy name, they are so powerful that when we chant Krishna's holy name, all our past sins, they all burn away to ashes. Just like a big sack of cotton can burn into ashes within seconds if it is burnt. So the holy names are so powerful that they can burn all our past sins. And none of our sins can be an obstacle for our vrata or for Krishna to give us our phala, that desired phala, that is devotional service. So in this way, Andar also tells about this. So, every song of Andar is so filled with meanings. We are just seeing some very superficial meanings and things like that. But every word, every syllable is so much filled with meaning it is said that just like a thief, if a police catches a thief and beats him up, he starts saying that, okay, sorry, I stole in this house, I stole in that house. And the more he's beaten, the more he starts revealing where all he has stolen and what all stolen goods he has. The more he's beaten, the more he starts revealing and he starts giving out those stolen goods. So it seems Andar's Sirpave is such that the more one studies, the more one hears, the more and more meanings come out of it. There are vidwans and speakers who are speaking on Sirpave since 40 years, 50 years. And they still feel that we have not done justice. We are not able to cover everything. There are so many more meanings left. So we can see this Sirpave from every angle. From the angle of Ramayana, from the angle of Krishna. We can connect it to Alvars. We can connect it to Dashavatar. We can connect every shloka to Acharyas, how it is actually speaking about the Acharyas. So in this way, there is no end to it. Like, I'll end with this one last point that comes in today's work. Today is the 10th day of this. So that is today's song, or we call it Pasuram in Tamil. They are trying to wake up one particular girl, one of the friend who has not yet come for this vrata. The vrata they are about to start. They are going around and trying to call all the girls who have not yet come. They are assembling everybody. So one particular girl, the fifth girl, has not yet arrived. So they go to wake her up. So when they wake her up, this particular girl, she continues to sleep. She does not respond from inside. So Andran and the girls from outside, they're saying, looks like you had a competition, a sleeping competition with Kumbhakarna. And Kumbhakarna also lost with you in the sleeping competition. And as a reward, the losing party has to give all their wealth to the winning party. So Kumbhakarna's wealth was his sleep. So Kumbhakarna has given all his sleep to you because the sleep was his property. He got this from as a vardhan from Brahmadev. We know that he had asked for a vardhan. He asked for nirdevam. There should be no demigods, no more devatas in this world. But Saraswati sat in on his tongue and made him say nidra astu or nidrevam. And Brahma immediately said Tathastu. So this was his property as he got in Vardhan. So he gave. So Andar is saying that looks like Kumbhakarna also lost with you in this sleeping competition and he has given this property of sleep to you. Now which Kumbhakarna, Andar says very nicely, which Kumbhakarna gave you this? The one who went and got himself killed from Lord Ram. Now why is I am translating it as it is in Tamil. It is not in active voice. Andar is not saying that Lord Ram killed Kumbhakarna. Andar is saying this Kumbhakarna who got himself killed by Lord Ram. So the voice is changed, active passive. So why is Andar saying like this? It is not a grammatical mistake, but very beautifully Andar is bringing out this point that the Lord comes down as incarnation. He does not come down to kill anybody. That is never his motive. That is just incidental. He comes here only for Paritranaya Sadhuna. He comes only for Sadhu to protect the devotees. But in the process of protecting devotees, some bad elements get wiped off. But that is incidental. That is not his main motive of coming here. And also, if Kumbhakarna wanted, he could have gone and surrendered to Lord Ram, like Vibhishan did. Had he done Charanagati to Lord Ram, then Lord Ram would have given him a place next to Vibhishan. He gave Lanka to Vibhishan, he would have given Ayodhya to Kumbhakarna. And with Vibhishan, like Ram said, that we were four brothers, now we are five. He included Sugriv, everybody in his list of brothers. So Ram, it seems, he would keep increasing that now we are 5, 6. So if Kumbhakarna had he come, he would have given him Ayodhya and he would have said, now we are 6 brothers. So Kumbhakarna did not do that. Instead, what did he do? He went and fought with Lord Ram, against Lord Ram. So because he did that, he got himself killed. Now, a very beautiful example is given for this. In previous ages, kings would construct very nice reservoirs of water for all the people. It's a very pious activity to construct water reservoirs so that people in the kingdom, they can get fresh drinking water. So in such reservoirs, people were allowed to drink water and perform their worship daily rituals. They were not allowed to take bath or bathe their cattle or even wash their hands and feet in that reservoir. So such reservoirs are even there now in many places. In South India also, if we go, there are places called Pushkarini where people can use that water for worship, but they are not allowed to take bath. So such kind of reservoirs were built. So one particular king, he built such a reservoir for drinking water purpose. And it was very beautiful. It was made beautiful with nice steps and gardens around it. So because there were gardens, it seems lovers would also come and sit there in the garden. So one particular lovers, they had a fight. And this lover, he decided to commit suicide in that reservoir. So he jumps into that reservoir, ties a stone around his neck, and writes in a chit that because I had a fight with my lover, I'm committing suicide with my own desire. He puts that chit in a plastic so that it is intact, and he commits suicide in that reservoir. So now there is a very big crowd over there, you know, to see what has happened. And when people see that, one of the person says that, see, this poor fellow, this young man committed suicide, very sad. All this happened because somebody constructed this reservoir. Had he not constructed this reservoir, this man would have not committed suicide. So this way this man started talking. So what do we understand from this? The reservoir was not meant for committing suicide. It was meant for supplying pure drinking water to people. But if somebody comes and instead of making right use of the reservoir, if he commits suicide in this, what is the mistake of the person who made reservoir or the reservoir itself? Similarly, the Lord comes here as avatar only to protect, only to do rakshanam. But when there are other bad elements or envious people who go and fight with the Lord and who do not surrender to him, then it is like they themselves commit suicide. The Lord does not intend to kill them. So this way, Andar brings out such beautiful gem-like meanings from her every pasuram. And in every syllable, we can connect it to a story, to Mahabharata, or even to Vedas, and to Ramayana, Bhagavatam, to many places like that. So this was a very small glimpse today of Tirupavai and the beauty of this beautiful month and month-long vrata of Andal. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much.
Why? Would like to ask anything?
Okay, so would anyone like to ask any questions here? I think there is some issue. Okay, Hare Krishna. So thank you everyone for joining. We'll continue this theme maybe next time. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.